Well, it's late May. We're on another camping expedition.
Beautiful day here in central Washington. We're expecting temperatures in the 90s, which we've been in the 60s and 70s, so.
Yeah, so this is a treat for us out here.
Looking forward to this weekend. This is the Yakima River behind me. Isn't that crazy? It's like we were saying earlier, it's been, you know, pretty moderate temperatures, and now all of a sudden this weekend it's in the 90s. This big warm trough came up and we have record temperatures, and so the snows are melting, the Cascades are melting like crazy. So look at this river.
Got some sage.
Oh good.
If I were these people, I'd be getting worried. This river is getting really high. And we've been seeing trees floating by, like huge pieces of debris just floating by.
This might be it, folks. This is like the last remnants of winter. I don't know.
Stupid winter.
It's like 90 degrees. We're sweating to death hiking with our shirts off and there's snow.
Alright, back there, that's Horsetail Falls. We're just driving along and sod on the side of the road. It's pretty cool. So we're here at Little Natchez Fish Ladder, and I'll show you what this picture looks like right here. So this is the fish ladder. Garrett was like up here, and this is the creek that comes up the fish ladder. And nice little flowing creek, right? Here's a big rock.
That's right there.
Anyway, this is what it looks like right now. This is like a monster. Monster. I don't think the salmon would have a very easy time of getting up that fish ladder.
Scenic boy tip of the day, never get into something you can't get out of. We just drove over all this water coming over the road, and we know the river's still rising. Should we continue on? Let's give this a think. Yes, but we're not gonna go too far. Hey, there's a beer can. Why do people put beer cans in the river?
Didn't leave it. What a good boyfriend. Saving the world one can at a time. Well, this is where we decided to camp. It's, pretty nice already developed campsite. There's a nice fire pit. Big open clearing right there.
As you're waking up to that in the morning. Can't wait.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
Cool chair. Coming up the big green chair. Well, friends, the Scenic Boys have had better days. We don't have the car anymore. We were driving to get water, came across this spot that had pretty deep snow. Hold on. Oh, okay, sorry, I'm back. Dusty found a feather. So anyway, we saw the snow patch and just figured maybe we could gun it, maybe we could go through it. And the Chevy is buried. It is deeply buried. We dug for an hour to try to get it out and It's super buried. So, sun's hanging low. We finally made it back to camp. We have everything we need to survive, which is kind of cool about camping and being stuck out here. Probably have to call a tow truck and see if they'll actually come up into this country road and hopefully help us. But I see it as a positive experience, I guess. I mean, how else can you view it? And it's going to be a great story, I hope, which is why I'm recording this. Oh, well, we just had dinner, sitting by the fire, and this truck comes blazing by, and we're like, I mean, you can't get any fire further because our truck is blocking the road, so they had to come back. And sure enough, they were coming back, so I ran out there with my light, and I flagged them down, and it was these cute guys. Lo and behold, they handed us a tow rope. We have procured a means to get out of here. That was so awesome of him.
Yeah, that's lucky of us too.
He's like, I got a tow rope, would that help you? I was like, yeah, that would really help us out.
It's about 8:20, and as you can see there behind me, we still don't have a truck because it's still in the snowbank. So Garrett's pooping, and then we are gonna go hike down the road to there's a few more people camped up the road.
Okay, that's us stuck in the snow right there. We got a couple of nice guys. They got a tow rope on us.
Yeah. Well,
and
they're...
Come on. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Woohoo! Ooh. Here we go, round two. Come on, get him, get him, get him, get him. Floor it! Come on! Yeah! Oh, sweet. We are saved. We are no longer stuck. Well, the water's still rising. Getting pretty close to the road here. It's not likely that it'll crest, but it's getting pretty high. There's still a bunch of people still camping up in there. Not us, though. We're not camping anymore.
So we got our truck back. We got everything we need, we're heading home, we're back on schedule, we'll be home by 4. Oh man. Good camping karma for as much shit as we could have been in.
Yep.
We had people helping us with tow ropes, people helping pull us out, never asked a thing of us in return. I love campers. Campers are good people.